The quality of our automotive designs becomes crucial as our cars get smarter and further integrated. We have more systems and subsystems in our vehicles' designs, requiring multiple serial buses, more hardware, and very thorough testing. And when you're designing a car that's going to be on the same road as your loved ones, safety is paramount. Learn how to fully test your automotive designs to prevent any errors, from the windshield wipers and the mirror controllers to the engine and brakes. Hi, I'm Melissa at Keysight Technologies, and in this video, you'll learn how to test and debug your automotive serial buses. This includes protocol decode and triggering on buses like CAN and LIN. I'll also cover how mass tests can help you find hidden dangers in your serial bus designs. LIN, which stands for Local Interconnect Network, is a slower, more affordable serial bus than CAN and CAN-FD. So it's usually used for communications with less critical functions in a car, like controlling the seat and mirror adjustments. You want them to work right, but you don't need quite the speed or accuracy required for other components in a vehicle, like the braking system. When it comes to vital functions that can heavily impact a passenger's safety, you'll control those with CAN or CAN-FD. CAN stands for Controller Area Network and is faster than LIN. CAN-FD is similar to classic CAN with the addition of flex data rate, meaning you can transmit more bits during the data phase of each frame. This is particularly helpful if you're trying to add more functionality into your vehicles and therefore need more nodes in your communication bus. CAN protocols also have additional safety controls built into them, such as the acknowledgement bit, which tells the system if the previous frame was valid or not, and arbitration, which lets you prioritize information from each particular node, ensuring that the most important data is not delayed. Knowing how to test all your automotive buses will ensure that at the end of the day, not only will you have a living customer, but a happy customer as well. If you're working on automotive serial buses, you probably have a protocol analyzer and an oscilloscope on your lab bench. The protocol analyzer is a great tool for looking at the trace flow of data, but it doesn't provide much, if any, information on your physical layer. Oscilloscopes are optimized for taking measurements at the application layer because of their ability to characterize analog signals. InfiniVision oscilloscopes also provide hardware-based decoding of automotive serial buses, which provides a real-time update of the decode trace. This is different than the software-based decoding you will find in oscilloscopes from other vendors. Combining the hardware decode with InfiniVision's speedy update rate of up to 1 million waveforms per second, and there's no lag in responsiveness, and you'll be more likely to capture elusive, problematic events. So let's take a look at these automotive buses on the scope and set up some tests. First, I'll start by probing a LIN bus. If you want to follow along with me and try out the automotive software for yourself, you can download the free trial from the webpage that we've linked on the screen or in the description. Once you have your signal connected to the oscilloscope, you need to set up the serial analysis. At this point, the scope is just receiving the signal without any triggers or analysis set up. First, we'll scale the signal on the screen so we can see it clearly. I can do this simply with the auto scale button, which will adjust my voltage and time scales. You can see it also centers the trigger nicely in the center of the waveform. Now we'll turn on the serial analysis. I'll tell the scope which type of bus I want to analyze and select LIN. Currently, my scope is set up to trigger on every rising edge. To get a more stable view of my signal, I'll set it up to trigger on the LIN bus instead. Now I'm triggering on the frames of the LIN bus, and I can see the hexadecimal representation of the decode at the bottom. I can also expand the lister view to see the decode in a table format. I can turn on segmented memory to view several acquisitions of my signal over time, allowing me to see each event and find all the errors that are occurring. Let's look at another example to decode a classic CAN bus. As before, I'm going to probe my CAN bus, scale it on screen, adjust my trigger, turn on serial analysis, and choose my bus and baud rate, which in this case happens to be 500 kilobits per second. And I'm going to set this up to trigger on CAN. You can get even more specific with your triggers and see the exact events you are looking for, such as a specific frame ID, different types of errors, or even particular bits. In this case, I'll trigger on frame ID 211. In this test, I'm going to take my setup a step further to make it even easier to understand the information I'm decoding. Below the waveform, we can see the time-correlated decode trace. This long string of hexadecimal characters at the bottom is the 8-byte data field of this particular frame. It can be a hassle to look up the corresponding information associated with this hex value. Instead, you can symbolically decode the hex values to see the meaning of each packet right here on screen. For example, this hex value could correlate to engine data and include its associated physical parameters, such as temperature or speed. To do that, it's as simple as importing your DBC file. All of today's vehicles have industry standard DBC files that define each CAN bus. In this case, the hex frame 211 that I set my trigger on is telling me information about my braking system, and I can see the actual torque value that the system is detecting. This is a much more convenient way to debug your system, since you can clearly identify which parts of your system are failing. Earlier, I mentioned that CAN and CAN-FD are used for the safety critical functions of your car, such as engine control and braking systems. Because it's so important to ensure these systems are working without fail, I'm going to use mass testing to verify my design even further. While the previous test can show you bit errors, mass tests can help you find more elusive errors that could be revealed when you look at the signal integrity of your serial bus. Keysight provides a set of standard mass tests for testing your CAN buses. If you're following along or would like to use these yourself, you can get them from the link in the screen or in the description. When you recall the mask file that fits your serial bus, the oscilloscope will automatically set up the eye diagram and the mask test. This lets you see if the rising edges of your signal are occurring at the correct time. If you want to learn more about eye diagrams and how they can help you test the physical layer of your designs, check out the video linked in the description. The mask test defines a fail zone, shown in gray. Signals should not enter this gray zone. If they do, the signal will turn red and you know that your design fails this test. This is an indication that noise could be interfering with your transmission and you have a higher potential for the receiver to misinterpret this bit. From this simple test, you can learn where you need to enhance signal integrity and reduce noise in your design. Equipped with these debug and analysis tools, you're ready to find any errors in your design and ensure you're creating reliable and safe automotive systems. You can test all the buses in your automotive design with the InfiniVision Automotive Software Package. This provides serial trigger and decode of CAN, CAN-FD, LIN, FlexRay, SENT, PSI-5, user-definable NRZ, and clock extension peripheral interface. It also provides advanced analysis including mass test, frequency response analysis, and advanced waveform math. You can learn more and download a free trial of the Automotive Software Package along with power measurements, USB 2.0 triggering and analysis, aerospace and defense software, and embedded analysis software by following the link in the bottom of the screen or in the description. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave those in the comments section below. And stay up to date with the latest how-to videos by clicking subscribe to our YouTube channel and following us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.